In this video, I will differentiate the square root of sine x, square root of cosine of x, and square root of tangent of x. So let's start with the square root of sine x. So square root of sine x . Okay, now just to talk about square root of sine x, what can you rewrite this as? You can rewrite this as sine x to the power of 1/2. Okay, now if you rewrite it like this, what do you see? You see that this is a function of sine x inside another function to the power of 1/2. So you can use the chain rule. So what do we do now? Oh, we can do this, right? We can let y equals to this function here, sine x to the power of 1/2. And then to use a chain rule, let's let u equals to sine x. Then what is y equal to now, right? Y must be equal to u to the power of 1/2, because sine x is u now. So this is u to the 1/2. Okay, so what do we have to do? Differentiate u with respect to x first. So du dx, what's that equal to? Well, we know that derivative of sine x is cosine of x. Next, we have to differentiate y with respect to u. So dy over du. What is that? Okay, so it's 1/2 u to the power of negative 1/2, because it's 1/2 minus 1 here. And we know that u is equal to, we say u is equal to sine x. So now we have to replace the u here. So dy over du is actually equal to 1/2 sine x to the power of negative 1/2. That's the same as 1/2 times, this is 1 over square root of sine x. Now, to differentiate square root of sine x, we're differentiating sine x to the power of 1/2. So what we're looking for here is, when we differentiate, is dy over dx, right? Differentiate y with respect to x here. So we're looking for dy over dx. And what's that equal to? According to the chain rule, it's actually dy over du times du over dx. Now you see that du and du cancel out. All you have left is just dy over dx. Okay, so now what is dy over du? It's this. So 1/2 times 1 over square root of sine x times, what's du over dx? Cosine of x. So times cosine of x. Now, group this together, you have 1. Okay, no. 1 times cosine of x is cosine of x. You have cosine of x, all divided by 2 times square root of sine x. So this is what it is when you group this together. Okay, so that's the derivative of square root of sine x. Now next, derivative of cosine of x. Derivative of square root of cosine of x. Okay, so now next, again, just look at square root of cosine of x first. Right? You can write this as cosine of x to the power of 1/2. Right? Again, it's a function cosine of x inside another function to the power of 1/2. So we have to use the chain rule. So we can let y equals to this function. And what can we do? We have to let y, let u equal to cosine of x. Then y must be equal to u to the power of 1/2, because we said u is equal to cosine of x here. So it's u to the 1/2. Okay, So according to Qing Lu, we'll take the derivative of u with respect to x first. So du over dx, and that's equal to derivative of cosine of x is negative sine x. Next, take a derivative of y with respect to u. So dy over du. That's equal to, and of course it's 1 half u to the power of negative 1 half. And we say u is equal to cosine of x, but we'll replace u here. So dy over du is actually equal to 1 half cosine of x to the power of negative 1 half. And we can rewrite this as 1 over 2 times 1 over square root of cosine of x. Okay, now, when we differentiate square root of cosine of x, we're differentiating cosine of x to the power of 1 half, which is this, right? And in order to differentiate this, we have to do, we have to take dy over dx, right? We're looking for this. So what is this? Dy over dx, right? I should put a question mark here, right? What is that? According to Qing Lu, it is dy over du times du over dx. Because du and du cancel out, all you're left just dy over dx. Okay, so now, what's dy over du? It is this, 1 half times 1 over square root of cosine of x. Times, what's du over dx? Negative sine x. Okay, so times negative sine x. Now, of course, we can group that together. Okay, put the negative sign to the front, so it's negative. Sine 1 times sine x is sine x on the top, divided by 2 times square root of cosine of x. Okay, so that's the derivative of square root of cosine x. Next, let's do the derivative of tangent x. Let's do it here. Okay, derivative of tangent x. Derivative of square root of tangent x. Oh, that's what I mean. Square root of tangent x. Right? Again, let's look at square root of tangent x by itself first. Right? What can you do? You can rewrite this as tangent of x to the power of 1 half. Right? Yes. And of course, you can see that, right? Again, it's the function tangent of x inside another function to the power of 1 half. So you can use the chain rule. And to use the chain rule, I will let y equals to this function here. Then I will rewrite this, right? But what can I do? I will let u equals to tangent of x, right? Then what is y equal to now? Since u is tangent of x, then y must be u to the power of 1 half. Yes. Okay. According to the chain rule, I have to take the derivative of u with respect to x first. So I have to do du over dx. And derivative of tangent of x is secant square x. Next, take the derivative of y with respect to u. And that's equal to, of course, 1 half u to the power of 1 over 2. And we said u is equal to tangent of x here. So we have to replace this u here. So dy over du is actually equal to 1 half. Now, tangent of x to the power of negative 1 over 2. And of course, I can rewrite this as 1 over 2. Okay. So 1 over 2 times 1 over square root of 10x. Okay, now, what's next? We're differentiating square root of tangent of x, which we're also differentiating tangent of x to the power of 1/2, which is this. How do we differentiate this? We're looking for dy over dx. Right? Yes. And what is dy over dx now? According to the chain rule, it is dy over du times du over dx. Now look at this, right? Du and du cancel out, all you have left is dy over dx. And what's dy over du here? It's this. 1/2 times 1 over square root of 10x times what's du over dx? Secant square x. So times secant square x. And the next thing is just to group this together, right? So it's actually, okay, secant square x on the top, all divided by 2 times square root of tangent of x. Okay, so that's the derivative of square root of 10x. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.